So when companies have these capacity problems, what can they do? Capacity planning strategies. This is where they come into play. So in this video, I'll talk about four different capacity planning strategies: lead, lag, match, and what we call an adjustment strategy. Remember, capacity planning is needed to support customer demand and to maintain production capacity as demand changes for specific products. Remember, it's not a one-size-fits-all all the time. Production can fluctuate throughout the year. When we think about seasonality associated with products, we may need more capacity at one point in the year and then another point in the year less capacity. And this is where we may want to exercise things like chase demand, right? Where we are varying the workforce to determine when we should increase production and decrease production. But here are four strategies that companies use when it comes to adjusting capacity or changing capacity planning strategies in order to meet customer demand. So first we have a lead strategy. Let's talk about lead and lag. You can look at lead and lag as proactive, lead being a proactive capacity planning approach, and lag being more of a reactive, conservative approach to capacity planning. So a lead strategy is when an organization says, we're going to be proactive and produce aggressively because we have that much confidence in our product. So if you take a company with a reputable brand like Apple and the iPhone, they have a very loyal base of customers that typically buy their products when they release new products. And because of that, they can have confidence in the amount of market space that they have, that when they release a new product, people are going to buy it. So they're not going to be apprehensive about how much they produce. If they have the capacity to produce 10 million of this new phone, they're going to be proactive and say, let's produce all 10 million because we believe these 10 million are going to sell fast. And for a long time, when Apple would release that new phone, people would be in line and they would sell out almost immediately across the nation. They employed a capacity planning, a lead strategy when it came to capacity planning. They probably produced as much as they could. And you ask the question, if they always sell out, why don't they produce more? Because they probably produced as much as they could, right? And then everyone else have to wait. They put them on back order and then eventually they get around to producing more. Now, another company that, let's say, produces cell phones may take the opposite approach of a lag strategy. Now, this is a more reactive strategy. We're not just going to produce tens of millions of units and know that they're going to sell because we either don't have the market space or data to support that prediction. So what we're going to do is we're going to produce a little bit of capacity. We add a little bit at a time and then we see how the market responds. Oh, we produced, let's say, 25,000 in this region. Oh, they sold out pretty quickly. Well, let's produce 35,000 in this region. So it's more of a reactive approach. Remember, lead is proactive. We know these things are going to sell, so we're going to produce to the max. Lag is more reactive. We're not going to maximize capacity until we know there's a reason to produce more output. And as we see that increase in demand, we will begin to increase our capacity to produce. Now, next we have is a match strategy and adjustment strategy. These are very, very similar. Match strategy is just that. We want to produce at the rate of demand. It's almost neck and neck. As demand hits, we're going to produce that amount. So think about the trend of ice cream or coffee. Statistically, research shows that ice cream sales spike during the spring, going into the summer months, and begin to decline during the fall and the winter months. And this cycle repeats itself year over year over year. And the coffee has an inverse relationship, right? During the spring and summer, coffee sales begin to decline a little bit more. And then when it gets cold in the fall and the winter, those sales begin to go up again. The inverse relationship of ice cream. You have a hot product that sells and a cold product that sells at different times of the year, but they're opposite. So based on when these products are selling, the companies that produce coffee, the companies that produce ice cream, they want a match capacity planning strategy because they want to produce in alignment with customer demand. They don't want to produce a ton of ice cream in the wintertime because it's not going to sell as good as it would in the summertime. And you don't want to produce a ton of coffee in the summer when it's going to sell better in the wintertime. So it'd be best to match these demands with the capacity to produce. So anytime you're thinking about when it would be appropriate to use a match capacity planning strategy, think about the product and how that product sells over a specific period of time. And last, we have the adjustment strategy. You can see here, this strategy adds or reduces capacity in large or small amounts over time. That's exactly what the match strategy does. The key with adjustment, though, is an adjustment has to be made in order for it to be called an adjustment capacity planning strategy. Here's an example. So, again, I used to work at General Motors, right? And let's say General Motors could produce 50 cars a day. If they're producing 50 cars and they're at max capacity, but then one of their competitors have this major recall and they're just getting all of these orders and they really need to produce 150 or 200 a day, here's what they can do. They can hire a contractor. They can expand their factory by, let's say, 100,000 feet to give them the capacity to produce more units. That's an adjustment because they had to change their system or the architecture of their building. A major change has to take place for you to increase or decrease capacity. Now, if for some reason they had a recall, lost sales, and they didn't need to produce that much, and they did a system change, let's say they changed their manufacturing system or whatever they used to produce their cars, that would also be an adjustment strategy, because they made an adjustment to their system. Remember, system or process has to change when it comes to an adjustment capacity planning strategy. So, key takeaways. Remember, lead and lag are quite the opposite. Lead is a very proactive capacity planning strategy, while lag is a very reactive capacity planning strategy. And match and adjustment are almost exactly the same, in which companies will add or decrease capacity based on customer demand. The only difference is with an adjustment has to be made to the system or the process of the company producing the product.